What it is, y'all? Welcome back to The Breakdown. Welcome to the Blue Light. And I am really excited to share an artist with you that you've probably heard but never heard of. And that would be Matt Carney. This is an artist I've heard several times live. One of my favorite songwriters and pop artists, but he kind of flies under the radar, though he has many hits. And this is a song that dropped a couple days ago. He's been releasing some stuff recently, and we're gonna break it down together. So without further ado, Matt Carney, let's see what you got for us today. This is Pontiac, which I drive a Pontiac. So we'll see what he has to say about it.
I used to worry about nothing, said I'd never grow up, and I fell in love, and it was enough until it wasn't. I used to dream that we could make it, but now I'm working on a paycheck, and the voice in the line says, I'm doing fine, can you tell that I'm faking? And we watch our friend.
All right, grooving, I like it. Starts out with just his voice. Really hitting us hard. Highly compressed, quick release. Don't worry about what that means.
I used to worry about nothing, said I'd never grow up. And
piano.
I fell in love, and it was enough until it was.
And a dope transition right here.
I used to dream that we could make it, but now.
Okay, so the bass comes in, but the rhythm kind of transitions in, and then there's a quick pause right after beat one of that second part of this verse.
Until it wasn't, I used to dream that we could make it, but now I'm working on a paycheck.
That's really cool. It kind of gives it a little bit of an extra spice. Instead of just coming right in, I think it kind of adds to that shuffling kind of feel that this rhythm is giving us. Notice how the hi-hat and the snare
and the voice in the line says, I'm doing fine, can you tell that
are really carrying the rhythm, and the kick is doing some interesting stuff.
I used to dream that we could make it, but now I'm working on a paycheck, and the voice in the line says, I'm doing fine, can you tell.
Doesn't seem to be following too much of a set structure. I really love holding back that hi-hat on just that single beat.
I used to dream that we could make it, but now I'm working on a paycheck, and the voice in the line says, I'm doing fine, can you tell that I'm faking?
All right, sounds like we're going to a pre-chorus here.
And we watch our friends play the same old game, and we all pretend that we're okay, we won't say, take me back to the time.
So a pre-chorus, the only thing that they added on this pre-chorus to help sell it as a new section is there's a bit of a voice drone just in the right ear.
And we watch our friends play the same old game.
I think that's the only element that they've added. They haven't really tweaked anything besides, I think it's a different chord progression, or at least they're kind of inverting the chords slightly differently, and then a different melody over the top. Very subtle.
I'll pretend that we're okay. We won't say, take me back to the time. Getting almost turning 25. Sing the CD that you burned me. We played it back.
About as basic of a transition to this course as you can have. Basically drops off for the last beat of that verse.
Take me back to the time.
And kind of the interesting thing is a lot of the production is the same. Same kind of feel on the piano, same rhythm. The bass isn't doing anything super special. What they've added is a double on his voice, on his lead voice. There's a couple other instances left and right, thickening it up, giving it some dimension. And then there are some droned chords, kind of like in the pre-chorus, but a lot more spacious. Some chords, just some oohs and ahs you can hear in the background there. And I think that's pretty much it. That's pretty much all. And the cool thing is that's all you need, really. This isn't, very intense of a production. It's kind of just this is very Matt Carney. It's not acoustic really, but it's subtle pop music. And so adding just a couple elements here and there, and on the chorus, really just using the voice, adding dimension to the lead, and then getting those oohs in there to kind of give it some extra chord structure is really all they're adding, and it sounds really great. I mean, the bass is doing a couple more interesting things there, but nothing really to write home about. Now, this hook is very cool. Let's listen to it. Told you that, no, you wouldn't crash. Maybe we went too fast. In your Pontiac. Cool. So we got a little vocal element leading us in there, No, you just to catch wouldn't our ear. crash. Maybe we went too fast. In your Pontiac. And two main things that I'm hearing. Number one, we have a filter out on the percussion. It's basically taking these audio spectrum, and it's slowly filtering out the high frequencies until all we get is that kind of lower and low mids. Maybe we went too fast. In your Pontiac. And then they've changed up the syncopation on the chord structure there. Do, do, do. Maybe we went too fast. In your Pontiac. My mom. And kind of a cool syncopation on the hook there, on the in your Pontiac part. Fast. In your Pontiac. My mama worried about my marriage, but now I'm worried about my parents. You can try to run from what runs in your blood, but you still gotta share it. Kind of doing the same thing in chorus two. The piano's there, they take everything out and then come right back on the next beat or two. My mama worried about my marriage, but now I'm worried about my parents. Notice how the bass is letting it breathe here in this first part of the second chorus. It's there, it's kind of supporting the kick, but I'm pretty sure this is just a full-on actual bass guitar, not like a synth. And the bassist is kind of giving you kind of staccato, very short notes. He's not letting it drone out. You can try to run from runs in your blood, but you still gotta share it. That's letting kind of the rest of the elements breathe a bit and doesn't sound as full. But as we transition to the second part of the verse, he brings back the drone. And we watch our friends play the same old game, and we all pretend. Take me back to the Interesting. So I think on in the first verse we had basically verse, pre-chorus, chorus, and now we've just gone verse, pre-chorus, chorus. So we kind of nixed second part of the second verse, and the chords are having a lot more fun on the piano. This verse, nice transition right there. The rhythm is still carrying it the same, kind of that shuffling hi-hat snare. That fun kick. Okay. We wanna say, take me back to Same the transition. town. Getting old, it's turning 25. You sing the CD that you burn me. We played it back. The way we laugh, windows down. Rolling around the south side of town. On your flip phone, you told your dad no, you wouldn't crash. All right, so what have they added? There's one thing different from chorus one. It's that sort of chorused electric guitar, just plucking a couple strings here and there, following that chord structure. Right here. hear it kind of plucking up that chord right there? One more time. Everything is the same. Cool. So it seems like it as a break or quote unquote bridge, and I don't know, maybe this next section will be the actual bridge itself. But really, as a break, they've just repeated the hook here. So we're keeping that filtered out percussion. He's even switched up where he says in your Pontiac. Maybe we went too fast. Cool. He kind of is bringing back those oohs and ahs in a more of a synthesizer like fashion, and you can hear it ducked under the kick. When the kick punches, it pulls back the audio on those oohs. Here, listen. Hear that? The piano, drive it. I used to worry about real life. Start to bring the filter starting to open up the filter again, kind of transition into whatever this next section is. I used to worry about real life until I fell into your eyes. I fell in love, and it was enough to make me realize. You take me back to the time. We're getting almost turning 25. Sing the CD. Alright, so there's no bridge, really. They recycle, they almost use a verse 3, I guess you could say. After this repeated hook. Same melody as the verse. I used to worry about real life. With just the piano and that guitar. I fell into your eyes. I fell in love, and it was enough to make me realize. But no pre-chorus. And we have a full-on transition into the chorus now. Before, we've had a very simple just pull back and then, you know, all together on B1. Now we have the bass kind of doing a walk down into this last chorus. To make me realize. You take me back to the time. We're getting old, we're turning 25. Sing the CD that you burn me. We played it back. The way we laugh, we lost down. Going around the south side of town. On your flip. Getting old, we're turning 25. Sing the CD that you burn me. We played it back. So I was listening to the bass there. I was trying to see it compared to chorus one. I actually think it's kind of doing the same thing. Because I noticed here on the second half of the chorus, kind of doing those staccato notes again, letting it breathe. And instead of letting it breathe here, I think it's actually, it's opening it up so the rest of the music can drive the song. So it's instead of letting it breathe and being more airy and open, it's almost letting the rest of the song punch through. But it's kind of achieving its goal there. And they do the same thing on chorus one. That's what I was looking back for. The way we laugh, we lost down. Going around the south side of town. Only flip on you, told your dad no, you wouldn't crash. Maybe we went too fast. I noticed they didn't use that little vocal element this time. I was waiting for it, but they didn't use it. Maybe we went too far. In your Pontiac. Pretty dope. again, ending with repeating that kind of hook element a bit. Oh man, I love Matt Carney. Yeah, Carney. I always screw up how to pronounce his last name. He's so chill. It's definitely pop, but it's so just. It's not in your face at all. It's very soothing, but at the same time melancholy, because you know he writes about really deep stuff and real life stuff. I think this production of this song really kind of highlights that. It fits him so well.